We all know too much alcohol is bad, not only from the fitness point of view, but also for your health in general. Today's video will focus on the effect alcohol has on muscle growth, athletic performance, and why alcohol makes you fat. Before I continue, I would like to say thank you for the 1000 subscribers I hit in the last weeks. It really means a lot to me, and I want to continue giving you the best high quality information. I highly appreciate all the people who like and comment my videos and support me in any way. Thanks a lot for that, and now let's talk about the alcohol. What actually happens physiologically when we drink alcohol? When we consume alcohol, or in terminology ethanol, it enters directly the bloodstream where it is transported through the blood circulation to the liver. There it is actually treated as a toxin, but more to that in a second. Physiologically, alcohol has a diuretic effect on the body, which basically means that alcohol dehydrates us. While diuretic means that the body produces much more urine. Biochemically, ethanol inhibits a protein called vasopressin, which is an antidiuretic, and this leads to the production of more urine. But why is the production of more urine actually bad? When our body produces urine, it extracts salt, vitamins, minerals, and fluid from our cells and from our blood, which at the end of the day leaves us dehydrated. And of course, the more urine we accumulate, the more often we need to pee. And if we drink too much alcohol, this can lead to an imbalance in our electrolyte household. It is generally said that 10 grams of pure ethanol leads to the production of 100 milliliters of urine. So how much is actually 10 grams? A quick comparison. It is generally said that one can of beer, one glass of wine, and one shot of a high percentage alcohol each have around 14 grams of pure ethanol. So beer and tequila should actually dehydrate you in the same way, right? The alcohol in beer of course extracts some fluid in us, but this is pretty well substituted with the liquid in the water which is already in the beer itself, which is not the case when we look at shots. So from high percentage alcohol, you will definitely be more dehydrated. And if you ever drank high percentage alcohol, then you definitely know what I mean. After you drink alcohol, what more or less immediately happens is that ethanol is degraded in your liver and a molecule called acetaldehyde is produced, amongst other things. And this acetaldehyde is really a bad thing, as it is also a carcinogen, like many other substances which you can find in tobacco, for example. And this can promote the development of cancer. And with that, we come to the effects alcohol has on muscle growth. Not only is acetaldehyde a carcinogen, it is also involved in a denaturation of proteins via adduct formation, while enzymes or in general proteins interact with acetaldehyde and get impaired or even destroyed. And if you want to build up muscle mass, an impaired cell metabolism and anabolism is of course the last thing you want. Studies could show that myofibrilla or muscle protein synthesis is reduced to up to 25% after you drank alcohol. And this obviously leads to much slower muscle repair and therefore less gains. The next thing is that alcohol also influences your testosterone levels. Minor amounts of alcohol can in fact raise the testosterone levels, which might explain the higher libido. But fact is also that this is not really significant. You really need to drink a proper amount of alcohol if you want to see a decrease of testosterone. And this drop in testosterone can also last for several days. Alcohol can damage the testosterone secreting cells, the so-called Leydig cells, directly. And furthermore, alcohol releases certain endorphins which can interfere with the testosterone synthesis. And additionally, alcohol promotes the conversion of testosterone into estrogen. I think you know that testosterone has a positive effect on muscle growth, but if you want to check for more details, check the link above. And now let's talk about why alcohol actually makes you fat. Besides testosterone, other hormones are also influenced. Inter alia, leptin, a hormone which makes you feel full. While alcohol inhibits leptin. The inhibition of leptin leads to more hunger, which can lead to a higher calorie intake. So you will probably not experience muscle gain, but more mass gain. The next important point is the energy metabolism from, for example, glycolysis or beta oxidation. As I already said in the beginning, alcohol is treated like a toxin. That means if we have ethanol in us, the body's priority is to detox our body from this alcohol. So it switches from the energy metabolism to the detoxification, while our body should be busy burning calories. So the energy is not used, but stored in form of fat. And not only that, your athletic performance will sink as well. And lastly, alcohol leads to a bad sleep. It's true that if you drink alcohol, it's easier to fall into sleep and also reach the REM phase, but this does not last for a very long time. Your sleep will be interrupted a couple of times, you might feel excessive thirst, so you will wake up, or you need to pee, or you just have headache. So the sleep quality is not the best after you drink alcohol. And important hereby is that muscle recovery and also fat burning happens a lot during night. And if you don't have enough sleep, not only your muscles, but your whole organism will suffer. If you want to learn more about the importance of sleep for muscle growth, check the link above. My take-home message is that alcohol is a poison to your body, so your body treats it as such. And regarding weight gain, alcohol itself does not make you fat, but indirectly, as excessive calories are preferentially stored in form of fat while your body is busy removing the toxin. Alright guys, hope you enjoyed this video. Leave a subscribe and like down there and subscribe to stay up to date. Stay healthy and see you next time.